We're Allison and James, a pair of adventure seekers with a passion for pushing our limits. We have been renovating this dilapidated 1968 Airstream Overlander for the past few weeks with a mission to turn it into our mobile adventure headquarters. Balancing the build while working in healthcare during a pandemic was proving difficult, but we were making progress one day at a time. Join us this episode as we transform the space with new flooring and start building our dream mobile kitchen. Welcome back to the Airstream. It's a beautiful winter's day. It's the start of February. One of the reasons I love Vancouver Island is because it's February and it's t-shirt weather. Discovered a few leaks inside the Airstream over the last couple of days. It's been raining pretty heavily and some of our subfloor beneath the window here has started to warp. I think there's some water trickling down here through the wall. There's a few holes on the outside which we get to deal with. So today's job is to try to work out some of those leaks. I recently found out that silicone cleans up with hot, warm, soapy water. Didn't know that before. But now I've got my silicone seams, all looking a whole lot nicer. Who would have thought? It's one of the troubles with doing these projects, is you're learning along the way and you don't really know what you're doing half the time. This morning I was doing some research and I was like, I wonder if there's any actual techniques to caulking and sealing things. Turns out there is, tons of them. Really helpful to know that stuff. There's a bit of a hump here, which if we lay our floor that we just picked up, it's gonna lay all weird over the top of it. So the idea is we're gonna take the belt sander here, and we're gonna try and clean up some of this wobble. It's arrived!
Yay! We've been waiting over a week and we're so excited to lay it out because we think it's really going to transform this space. So,
let's get at it.
Let's do it.
Well, that's a wrap. Got all the floor laid out. Just gotta tidy up a few pieces, trim along the edge there by the door. But otherwise, she's looking pretty snazzy.
But it is midnight and I am damn tired. So it's a wrap for tonight, folks. See you next time.
I brought you breakfast. It's a Chipotle hash bowl.
You did the egg perfectly. Look at that gooey little fella.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Some veggies, broccoli, spinach.
Oh, really good.
Well, I'm pretty stuffed after that, but that was
amazing.
Pretty tasty.
Yes, it was.
We had a late breakfast because we spent the entire morning running around getting all the supplies we need for this weekend's build. So got tons of wood, looked at potential countertop options, and bought our new propane stove and oven. And the reason why is because today we're getting stuck into building
cabinets.
Cabinetry. James and I love cooking, so we are so stoked to build a tiny kitchen in here.
I'm really excited to build cabinets. I've never gotten to build them before. It's been a good excuse to go buy a couple of tools, which I've, you know, kind of always wanted to have, but never had an excuse to go out and buy. So it's going to be a learning process, but I'm stoked.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's get at it.
Let's get into it.
Got all our pieces cut, we're gonna have to do all of our pre-drilled holes with our Craig's jig, and then we'll be ready to glue and screw it all together. So I only recently became aware of the Craig jig. It seems that you don't always have to countersink your holes from the when you're doing these butt joints. You don't always just have to countersink them from this direction. You can use this groovy thing called the Craig jig, and you want to make little pocket holes on the inside, and that way you don't have any exposed screw holes. So, I've never used one before. It seems pretty simple. So let's give it a try on this bit of test wood before we go doing it on the frame. Well, there you go. That's pretty amazing. These are the right screws. They're 1 1/4. We're using 3 1/4 inch plywood at the moment. And I believe 1 1/4 is the right length screw for this thickness of plywood. Man, they grip really well. That is freaking awesome. Gonna change my life. This cabinet here, I think was gonna be a stack of 3 drawers. And then right next to it, this is gonna be the enclosure for the oven. So it'll eventually sit just about here. But for now, we're just gonna pop it down there. We still need to build the cabinets that are gonna run underneath, and then another big set of drawers that are gonna sit over here.